Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Shadows of Arm. Enhanced Edition of Blind, we're here with Madolf and friends.
Avert your eyes, Dark Elf. I'll not have you taint the beauty of the wood with your poison gaze.
Oh, now Jahira and Viconia are about to go at it. Viconia's been picking on Airy.
Would you deny me even the sight of the trees, Jahira?
I can appreciate the strength of the oaks, even though I would never live amongst them. I am not to be swayed by your words, creature. I know too much of you and your kind. Ooh, such delicious fire. Though better it was turned on an enemy, I would be your ally, Jahira. Your strength might even bring you respect among my kind. Lies. Such a speck would grant me naught but a bigger tombstone, or a nameless grave in a slightly nicer tunnel. Granted, you might not live to make that favorable impression, but I still say it is so. Take that as you will. Very interesting clash of personalities here. Anyway, we still have this stuff to explore. Let's head east and check this stuff out here, and then we'll fill this out and then walk back over, and then we need to talk to Minister Lloyd. I haven't forgotten about Valigar, though. Definitely not.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Let's see if there's anything lurking in the forest over here. A bunch of trees chopped down. I guess that's the villagers doing that? I did notice that before. Well, the forest here is too thick to pass. Still want to clear the fog of war as much as possible without using that clairvoyance spell. Kind of like cheating in a way, that's my opinion. Okay. Alright, that's it for that. That was quick. Just passing through, guys. We'll pass along your message shortly. Brown bear. Oh! We got something here. A cave. Umar cave. Huh. Right under Valigar's cabin. I wouldn't be surprised if it is a ladder or something that leads up to the cabin from the cave. Maybe Valigar's behind all this stuff. Turning people into werewolves. Maybe shape-changing people. Polymorphing them. Alright, well, we explored this a lot quicker than I thought we were going to. Well, yeah, let's go. Yeah, let's just go talk to the minister, I guess. Brown bear's killing everything. Hi there.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Yes, my lord. Is there something you need? I have spoken to the ogre, Madolf, and I do not believe he nor his followers are responsible for Imnisvale's problem. What? But I was sure that those monsters were the killers. What makes you so certain that they are not? Madolf has had his own people go missing, much the same as yours. He is as worried as you are. Oh, that isn't good news at all. If ogres can be worried, What should we be? Actually, Madolf sent me with a proposition. He and his people will provide protection for the village in exchange for peaceful relations and a bit of trade. He has? I must say, that might not be such a bad idea. If this ogre can be trusted, that is. Thank you for bringing this to my attention, my lord. I will have to go and talk to them, I suppose. We could both benefit from this. Since the ogres are no longer a possibility, all I can suggest is you go to Morella's cabin. There must be some evidence of what has happened to her. Yeah, I have done that. I have informed him, blah, blah, blah. With the ogres eliminated as a possible source of the murders, Minister Lloyd has suggested that perhaps I go to the Ranger Morella's cabin to the southwest of the village and look for clues there. Well, I've already done that. And here, described. I informed Minister Lloyd about Madolf's offer, and the mayor was not entirely opposed to the idea. He has agreed to talk to the ogre and see what sort of arrangement can be made. Helm's patience, my lord. Whatever are you thinking of buying... What? Whatever are you thinking buying our son Val's been anything? Now he's gone and run off to act like a fool and probably get himself killed. Shame on you. We bought him ale. At least we didn't buy them swords. Alright. He came out of us... He ran out a sacred door. He's gone. Yeah.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Well.
Stand back for justice.
Never had rights. No,
no sorry. I think they said that before. We're all here.
It is done.
We're scattered. We haven't seen ourselves through our room yet, even. Sleeping woman says zzz. What time is it? Probably late. Oh, it's like 1 a.m. I don't feel like striking out at 1 a.m.
You're not mercenaries, are you?
No.
Oh, I ate those money-grubbing scum.
No, not entirely mercenaries. Sometimes we act as if we are. Alright, it should be like 9 a.m. or something. Yeah.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run! Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
It's been some time. I wonder if he's come back to his cabin. I mean, that's not why we waited, but. He's back! Hi.
Butt kicking, for goodness!
Well, I've spoken with the... with Madolf. They just want to live in peace. In exchange, we'll have someone to protect us. And the merchants are looking forward to it, too. Madolf wants to come to town to purchase supplies and things. That should be quite a sight. But Thank you, Sapphire. I wouldn't have thought of negotiating with those creatures. This will be better for Imnisvale all around. A peaceful arrangement has been set up between Madolf and his fellow deserters and the village of Imnisvale. The deserters will protect the village, and the village will allow them to live in peace and perhaps even trade with them once in a while. Overall, a satisfactory arrangement. I believe the wolves, or wolf-like creatures, are responsible for your problem. If that is the case, my lord, then I beg you to go and destroy these wolves. They cannot be allowed to continue their carnage. And he's stuttering. Please, you agreed to help my village, and I ask that you not abandon us now.
You look like a good enough sort.
Thank you, even though I did give your kid ale.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
So I wonder if these merchants will speak about this now. Elence Fielding. I don't know if that is a
merchant. Greetings, good customer. A pearl to you.
I don't think she's saying anything different.
You'll find no better prices in Arm. I guarantee it.
No, he's still talking about the ogres coming down to kill him. Okay. Be careful of the hungry ogres. Alright. Well, I wonder where these kids might be. Can we run into them? Find them? Dar. Did we talk to Dar before? Oh, he was the one who wanted to get rid of that mage inside here. Hello again, stranger. Still upset, huh? Why is that? Yeah, I read this. Maybe Katya knows where these kids are. Yeah, wolf monsters. Yeah, I read that. Alright. Well, I don't know about going out and looking for them. I have a feeling we'll just run into them at some point. I guess we'll go to the Umar cave. We'll try to see if it really does lead up to Valigar's cabin. Yeah. West of the village. Well, that's the cabin there. Must say also means that cave. We enter.
I swim in memories in such a place as this. Most unpleasant memories.
Mm-hmm. So what is that? It's like guts laid there or something?
All the world. I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
Hmm. That just disappeared, whatever that was. Failing. Hmm. Maybe get in the shadows? Try it.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Hmm. Trap on the chest? What? No.
Fleet of foot and all that.
It's a mimic. That's awesome. I've never come across one of them in a game before. Like, you know. Only in pen and paper games, so I'm saying.
You point, I punch.
Well, since it's probably just gonna sit there and not move? I'm not completely sure. Oh, what is this? Dart of Stunning? Oh! I'm held? Why am I held? I am not Kalis. Fear. Oh. Remove paralysis. An area effect.
Yes.
Yes.
Swords, not words.
No, darts, not words. Thank you. Now, after all that,
I'm ready, I think.
Yoshimo is willing.
Is it a regular chest now? Apparently, it's also a chest. Mimic's blood and a diamond. The blood of a mimic which you have killed. Mimic's blood is often used in the creation of golems or golems. That's cool. We can make one of those maybe someday. Bullet plus one. Dart plus one. I'm sure I've read this in the first Baldur's Gate, but anyway, diamond is a hard, clear gem which can be clear blue, white, rich blue, yellow, or pink. The hardest of all the gemstones and among the most valuable, diamonds are usually found in the northern mountains by underground races and then traded to the surface world. Indeed, bullet plus one. Ugh. I can't put it there because of my magic, minute miniers. Can that go in something? I'm gonna put it in the bag of holding. Oh, got this too. Regular bullets. How sad. Bolt plus one. Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna just drop these. I hardly ever have him use the darts. So we really don't need any more. Alright, so we're back to using swords. Okay. Cannot save it this time.
You're right behind me, right?
Okay.
All the world is blind to my passing.
There's a Neller over here who we can apparently talk to. Derbert? Didn't we run across a Derbert? Oh, these are the kids, right? I think these are those kids. We gave them ale. I guess they came here and just passed out.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Well, if we could save them for whatever's might be lurking here, that would be a good thing. Oh, I'm meant to press tab.
All the world is blind to my passing.
They're all here. Oops.
Very well. Hiya. Minsk and jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
All the world is blind to your cutter.
We can loot that.
All the world is blind to my passing. Nature could find a home here if it were properly
cleansed and balanced. Cleansed and balanced, huh? Really? That it? I guess that's it. Can we wake them up and we'll just go? Derbert.
Excuse me.
Generic drunk guy wave sound.
I's being hick so glad it's to see ya. Hick, you so nice to us boys, I guess. Hick.
Idle hands. I stumbled across the three kids from Indusvale for whom I bought the ale. They were drunk and passed out in a cave outside the village. I wonder how long they've been missing for. No doubt that keg's going to last them a while. Heh. Alright, well, hopefully they're safe in here. Balbin's too busy to talk. And Neller is too busy. Derbert will never say this.
Excuse me.
You're excused. I guess that's the way out. Huh. I guess they weren't interested in the chest. Probably too drunk to see it.
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
Now we can save. It was their drunkenness that was distracting us from being able to save. Alright, so just the Umar Caves, nothing much there. Maybe we should return and tell them, and then we can
live by the sword. Live a good long time.
We'll go here, and then we'll visit Jermien's home. I'm not sure if we're going to find...
I can't help but remember what the forests in the north look like from the sky. They're so majestic.
Indeed. I guess the ones attacking the village are in a different zone than this. Unless it's Valigar behind it all. Maybe he's a mage and a werewolf. Let's go see if we have a way to tell them we found them.
Stand back for justice!
Okay.
See, battle bow? Run, bow, run!
Do we have to talk to somebody about... I'm just going to run through these people here really quick. Because there were three kids. Unless they're all brothers. Some of them are not...
I am at peace in the outdoor places, though it never seems to last.
Some of these people... two of these kids might have other parents, so let's see if any of these people are their parent.
Greetings, good customer. A pearl to you.
Useful gadgets I have. Yes, I do.
Huh. Good. I think I like the backside of you better anyway, getting smaller as you walk away. How rude.
You'll find no better prices in Arm. I guarantee it.
Alright, we'll check in here.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Well met and welcome!
Oh, I can't believe that my poor baby got a hold of a barrel of ale. When I last saw him, he was so pale, it looked like he was going to just up and die. He was so drunk. Alright, well, we don't have an option to tell her that we found them. We know where they are. I don't think Sleeping Woman's going to wake up. Book merchant. Mm.
Butt kicking for goodness.
Alright, we found him.
And who might you be?
Jeb? Yeah, he was the one who told us about that chicken. Any other option with Dar that would do anything? I'd rather try to reason with him. I don't know.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Just the same.
Fine.
Trust is for the foolish and the dead.
Faster than Jake. Take a fast pause.
Or the foolish dead.
I am willing.
Alright.
Yes, Abil?
Never call me that. I've killed people for less. Alright. Protection from evil. Mirror image. Wait. Mage spells? Yeah. Blur. And then chant probably won't even last long enough because we're not in combat. A turn passes like that if you're not in combat. So, who has haste memorized? Hopefully one of us. Yes. All right, in we go.
Such menial tasks.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
You need something, stranger.
Eh? Who disturbs me? I am Minsk. Who are you? Oh, that's a golem. Minsk, eh? Well, I don't recognize your name. So long as you're not sent by that fool, Dar, I'll not object to your presence. Well, that's mighty nice of you, considering we just barged into your house. And I, since you ask, am none other than Jermien, licensed cowled wizard for this region, so you needn't run off and attempt to report me, boy. Boy. All four, yeah. You're a cowled wizard? Then why don't you do something about the killings around here? I don't do anything about it because I don't want to do anything about it. I have more important things to do, and until the cowled wizards tell me otherwise, I'll not involve myself. Can you tell me what you know about these killings, then? It's likely wolves or ogres or some other mundane nonsense. I've no interest in the matter. Why don't you ask some of the yokels if you're so concerned? What is this thing you're making? Or just standing around with? Ah, glad that you asked. This, my friend, is nothing other than a golem of stone. A fine piece of magical craftsmanship, if I do say so myself. And I do. Few other mages have made the attempt, you see. This type of golem is quite powerful, or golem, sorry, is quite powerful and dangerous, but I am more than skilled enough to control it. Once it's complete, I'll have an excellent servant, and something to keep an eye on my daughter and that foolhardy beau of hers while I'm away. Trouble is, I'm missing one of the crucial ingredients, the blood of a mimic. Just found that in this episode. I'd pay handsomely for some, in fact. You look like the adventurous type. Care to find me some? Huh. We might not have the option to say, yeah, we have this, because it's in the bag of holding. Just curious what he would say. What's a mimic, and where would I find one? A mimic is a vicious little creature, shape-changer, that likes to attract and kill adventurers by looking like a treasure chest or similar objects. They generally exist in dungeons, ruins, and similar places, although a way you would find one around here, I haven't a clue. That's why I'm looking for some. I am saving coin to rescue a friend. What would the reward be for this task? I seem to recall that I've got a magical sword around here that I won in a bet from that fool Tolgarius. I've no use for it, but it's valuable. Find me some mimic's blood and it's yours. Okay. Yeah. Magical sword Tolgarius. That's the guy in the government building we keep talking to. Sending us after Valigar. I'd like to ask, love to ask him if he knows anything about Valigar. Alright, I'll make the attempt. I have it. Fine, I wish I could point you in the right direction, but if you do find me some, you know where to find me. Off you go then, boy. Find Mimic's blood. I must find some Mimic's blood for the cowled wizard Jermien for the juggernaut golem he is building. Golem he is building in the village of Imnisvale. I used to always say golem, but from what I've been hearing, golem is the name of the creature in Lord of the Rings. Golem is the thing sitting here. Oh, there's someone else here as well. Oh, Colette is the one. Okay. I didn't realize she was there. Standing right there the whole time. Alright, well, guess what? Without moving from our spot, we found it. Ta-da.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Ah, it is you again, boy. I don't suppose you find any of that mimic's blood, have you? Yes, I do have some, in fact. Eh? Let me have a look at what you have there. Yes. Yes. I see. Well done, boy. Well done. I don't know how you found it, but here it is. I took the liberty of digging out that sword earlier, just in case. Rather prophetic of me, don't you think? It was just collecting dust anyway. So here you go. And well earned, I might add. Now, all I need to do is add this to the golem and he will be complete. Finally, I will be able to leave in peace and be assured that Colette will not be molested while I am gone. Is this supposed to happen? Sounds like he destroyed it. Ugh. Stone golem going, Yes! Awake, my creature! Awake and hear my command! Rawr. Eh? What is wrong here? No! No, stay back! Back! I command you!